parcel theft is relatively common. Auburn Police Area Command had approximately 170 cases last year, ranging from 10 a month to up to 30 a month.
我丢了两个包裹，我当时第一个丢的包裹是一对耳钉，大概是280刀左右，然后后面丢的一个包裹是三件衣服，总价大概快800刀。就是包裹是前一天下午1:30的时候到的，然后我是第二天晚上大概7点不到才回的家，然后我一看那边就是他拍照给我的地方已经没有我的快递了，我就知道我的快递丢了。然后第二个包裹它也是这个公司的，然后它是前一天晚上到的，然后我当时没有收到，没有看邮件，然后我是第二天一大早大概8点多看到邮件，我就马上下去拿了，但是也已经没有了。就是放在我们那个公寓进来的ground floor 那边，它放在那个快递柜的旁边，我也不知道为什么没有放进快递柜里。快递柜有锁，因为它要有一个 access code 和你的手机号同时输入进去，它才能把那个快递柜打开。我当时是先去找我们 building manager 说，然后他跟我说让我发邮件给物业，然后说要查监控，然后我发邮件给物业以后，他们就也没有回复我邮件，然后我就报警了。然后报警是6月份报的警，但是我前两天大概上个礼拜又打电话问了一下那个警察，他又说这个案件到现在还没有查出来。
首选的第一条肯定是你在下单的时候，在留给运输公司地址的时候，那肯定是反复确认你的联系方式是准确清晰简单明了，这是最行之有效的方法。根据我们的数据显示，基本上所有的盗窃或者是破损案例有90%应该是由于联系方式不准确。如果您觉得您的产品非常的重要，比方说一些重要的文件资料，那么我们强烈建议您选择receive with signature， 绝对不能授权给运输公司直接留在您的家门口。而对于高价值的产品，那么我们就强烈建议您购买相应的保险。
To avoid the parcel being stolen, it's best that you arrange a time for delivery when you are home.Alternatively, if you can't be home, if you can arrange for a neighbour or someone that you trust to collect the parcel on your behalf. If you live in a unit block, you may have the opportunity to use a secure room. Once you've found that the parcel is lost or stolen, what you need to do is report it to police as early as possible. That gives police the best opportunity to investigate and try and identify the offender and recover the parcel. No value threshold. It's important to know that although something may be of low value, the offender or offenders may have committed multiple offences. So it's important for us to try and identify who are stealing these parcels, as it may affect multiple people. If you require any further information, we have flyers available that give information on parcel theft, on mail theft and theft of food delivery boxes. You can access these flyers on the New South Wales Police Force internet page and the Auburn Police Area Command Facebook page.